Fox Look at Sharpe Trades. Positive day overall on Wall Street. The market has a little more confidence between the US government making steps to ensure some form of package, stimulus package moving forward. And the G7 committing to sustain this economy no matter what. So the market like the at least some sort of confidence that we have several agencies and groups working together. We discussed the potential for a bounce a few days ago when it was so last Wednesday, and it was making this couple of indecision bars, the spinny top and then the doji on the 18th and the 19th of March. And they opened up positive, but then rolled over to come support 220. That was a key area going back the end of 2018. And rolled over, and yesterday found the bottom here at the chair bottom and 221. Got a bounce, then bullish kicker on low volume. Notice the low volume. This is always concerning the bullish kicker on low volume. It's not confirmation yet, but you know, we take it. And it's closing right at the 18. This is an important area. We're looking for this kind of close or even slightly higher, but this is positive. Now, we're right against this big resistance, the ATMA, first of all, and then this high on the 18th, 248.37. But if we can break above the area and extend, possibly test the channel and see what it does at that point, and move above that, there could be a potential. We 1, 2, 3 bounce rally. So we'll see what comes out of this first move today. So the next area to look at the trend line near 248, 250, and we got 260, 74. That's the next resistance. Above that, 273 and the 21 simple the moving average. One day at a time, let's not jump in full power. Market is, governments are shut, I mean, the countries are shutting down, the India shut down for 21 days. So, and states across the US are also shutting down, telling people to stay home. So things are not in motion yet, but they're trying to find ways to restore some sort of economy back into motion. Anyway. Let's buy the NDX is a little better. Yesterday was a much more convincing move compared to the S&P 500. Today, good move above the 73.28 resistance. It popped and reached the channel top. This one was led by NVIDIA. Made a very good move today. So semiconductor are leading the NDX is the the semiconductor technology index or lead today. And big resistance here, 75. Let's see if it breaks out this area, 78.81, the next resistance, and the 21 simple, the 20 simple, the moving average, this red line right there. And quick look, however, I want to point out the VIX, the volatility index, is up. So despite the market excitement, or little excitement, the fear is still there. You can see it rolled over. This is the volatility index, the fear index. When market goes down, this one rallies. As you can see, market has been in the toilet. This has been moving up very steady. This is something you cannot buy or sell. But it's an indicator to use, engage, gouge how the market is moving. And today, as you can see, a lower shadow, this is buying opportunities all the way down, went up to 36, a major reversal. So this is a buying up against the resistance 6 months. The ETF related to this is the UVXY and the TVIX. So those are products people utilize to trade VIX. This is the 2-time inverse ETF. The UVXY is the 1.5-time inverse ETF. Anyway, so those are other things you need to trade VIX. But the point is that despite the market move, the fear indicator is still up. See, big mover. So anyway, let's see what comes out of the next couple of days actions. And this one, keeping up this one, if it breaks out of this resistance trend line, then the fear is back in the game and we're going to see it in the market, 75, 92, 116, and 146. I want to take a look at the trades we took today and some of the swing trades that are actually working quite nicely, especially now the market is turned around. So starting with BA, Boeing, we initiated the trade 3 days ago. 3 days ago, yeah, right there. When it pulled back, held this primary support at 84, consolidated nice, and then yesterday popped Monday. Good move, reached the first target at 114. Today, made another positive move in the after hour market. As you can see here, 133. That's my second target. Very good. Reached second target. Now we are tightening stops, 120 and 102. So this one came down very hard, 74% in a couple of, in 4 weeks. So we are on a possible 50% retracement. It's a possibility. I mean, I don't think it's going to get that far high. But first, we're looking at our next target is 153.31. They will be near the 23 Fibonacci retracement. Above that, the 38 Fibonacci retracement, 191. And then if we're lucky, we can get all the way up to 50. But folks, with this market, don't play games. In the market, they can roll over anytime. So right now, we're catching bottoms. But don't fall in love with those stops because they can roll over. If you are a long-term investor, on the other hand, those are very good prices. But again, consider that the market is, we are heading towards a recession if you're not there already. So we could expect, besides a lot of volatility, also price to continue to move either lower or sideways. So we might retest some of those lows in the next few months. We don't know. Right now, no, the airlines, nobody's traveling, but people are traveling, so those are all shut down. On the positive side is that when you have a positive move like that, there is a sense that the government is going to step in and provide some assistance, financial assistance for those companies. And that's and we are seeing that across the airlines as well. We traded Delta Airlines today. It was very good as a day trade and swing, reached a couple of targets in a day. So this was Boeing. Chef, another, it was a day trade that worked very well. Typical inside the 1 year chart. Which is the chart we use for day trading, comparing 1 minute with the hourly and the daily chart. This one had a good pop right after the market opened, and then a pullback found a base at 782, secondary stop 780. A good consolidation formed an ascending triangle. That's usually a good indication when you have a big move in the pre-market, right there. There. With good volume right at the open, a pullback consolidation to testing 10 where the support is, as consolidation, and then it was pressing this resistance at 869, pop pullback, went through opportunity, ran to my first target at 981. And then a pullback consolidation, usually during the lunch hours, things quiet down a little bit. This did quiet down here around the 11, 30. And then going into the close, he accelerated. And in the after market is up at 1075. This for me, this was done here when he reached this area of the position. But then he broke the channel. Even though the VWP held there along, all along, which is always a positive indication. And again, in the after market is up slightly. Now let's see if this one extends. This got crashed. This is in the sector of food distribution. So it might crack a little bit up, especially with this kind of big volume, bars. Next target moving up, if he extends, 11, 83, 14, 16, and 19. This again was just a day trade for us, done. Delta Airline was a fantastic trade, both a day trade and a swing trade. And the day trade, right at the opening, sent a message that was stabilizing quite nicely above the 24.70 support. Yes. Good consolidation. When you have this kind of big pop on volume and price back and holds steady, this is a very positive indication and actually an easy trade. You set stop a few pennies below the low. the low here was 24.50. So that was the stop. And actually we had two stops, 25.20 and 24.50. A good consolidation, it was below the VWAP, but we didn't see any big downward volume or upper volume, only this big one right here at the opening, which was a good indication that this was going to make a move. You could go at either side when you have this kind of big volume at the opening. But in this case, the sentiment was positive, and then at some point crossed back above the VWAP, took out the resistance trend line. Around this area, I sent a message also to our swing groups as a swing trader. And it started working, reached the first target at 26.89. And then consolidated a little bit more, pulled back, return support, the VWP flirted with that a little bit. But as you can see, the channel bottom was holding and held nicely right at the 25.50 level. 60 level, and then up some more, push the resistance at 27, and then eventually was able to break out and reach near my second target, which was 29.31, as 29. I closed my position, nice day trade for us. As a swing also, a potential to extend, but then was an announcement that Moody or Standard & Poor's downgraded the company, BBB, basically junk. And that's what caused this rollover that took out the VWP. However, it was able to recover. And as you can see, the aftermarket is going up a little bit. It's now near 28. Now I send a message to the group also highlighting this, this situation. Let's see. In a chart, so let's go back. As you can see, I highlight these three areas. These are the opening big upper volume. One is the bigger the following day, yesterday, and then much bigger today on the 24th. So this is institution buying large quantities. Those are high orders. Big buying and with a base at 2050. So seems like Delta has found a base at 2050. So that's an area. If you're a long-term investor, you want to set up your position for re-entry opportunity. If price comes back down there, or stop if it moves below it. For swing trading, obviously, that's way too risky because you know, it's from where it is now. Let's take a closer look. So today, this one gave us the entry at 25.10. Gave us a good 16% And as a day trade, that was great. As a swing trade, 7%, but if it comes down and tests 20 feet, that's an 18% drop. That's too risky. As a swing trader, you want to risk maximum 4, 3, 4, 5%, 8% if your position is small, okay? But this one seems to have found the base. And again, if the government steps in and start bringing support to these companies, possible bailout was in the discussion. We might see those prices move higher, 29, 31, 31.77, 34, 37, and 41.67. Those are our next targets. If this thing continues to move higher, be careful though, and don't fall in love with stocks because those things can roll over very quickly, especially with these market conditions. Yeah, this is one of the virus related stocks. Now we have we had six in our list. I'm going down to three because many of them, the market is understanding that there's not going to be any virus, antivirus production for at least a year that's valuable to the market. So all that excitement is now fading away a little bit, but I'm still keeping an eye on three. Guild is one of them. Guild is one of the drugs, actually, the treatment that could be beneficial to the fight against this virus. It's holding the 50 simple the moving average, all with all the virus and the stocks, we have larger support resistance areas just because the volatility can be extreme. So you use more positions, and you keep the stops a little more wider so you don't get stopped up. But also when it reaches second or third target, take your profit, just like we did here. Popped, rolled over, popped, rolled over, popped, rolled over. You got your profit, otherwise you end up in red. And now looks like is stabilizing with some lower shadows and holding the 50 simple moving average. I usually like these kind of consolidations. This hasn't breaking out quite yet. It's waiting for big news if it happens. The vaccine is going to be approved for the treatment of coronavirus, or if they start going to see efficiency of the treatment itself. Right now, they haven't seen any of that. So we're looking for our targets, 80.6, which was reached a few days ago, 85, same. And then above that, 89, 94, 98, and 104. The support is 72, and the 50 simple moving average is 69. I know another of these virus stocks is moving sideways, was covered in CBS, it was on Sunday. 6 minutes for a fantastic swing for us through here, and then it's those are very dangerous. So if you trade them as very small positions, and if for some reason break support and you're still holding the position, don't hope reverse or close the position, because those are very risky. You can lose more than you anticipated. Very risky, very volatile. You can also provide a profit, but this is the game, and this specifically is not making move you're looking for. CHK, CHK has yesterday initiated the trade when he was pulling back and in testing this 21, was a support around 22. Unfortunately, it took out the primary support, super tight at 21.70, and then the secondary support was 21. It came slightly below it, 20.67, before reversing today. We could have our resistance, which was 21.70. Send the message as this thing was making a little bit of a move around 22.50. And it seems like it's trying to recover at least. I like the action a little better. Certainly, yes, it was disappointing, but today seems to have turned around. Now, need more volume to confirm this consolidation. This one moves rather quickly. It was 32 a few weeks ago, and now it's down to 19, 20. So let's see, there is some resistance trend line at the level, that's one. And then there's another one at this level, more, will be wider, that'll be a while for now. But anyway, if this one, as long as it continues to hold the 21 and 21.70 area, the secondary primary support, I look for a retest and break above 23.59, this is our first target. Above that, resistance trend line, which could be near 25.60, 24.60. 25.61 and 27.66 are the next two targets. Let's see if this makes a move. As I see here in the 1 minute chart, there is, where did it go? 1 minute chart, big volume, 200, 300,000 volume shares. This is a good indication of dark pool. Get published after market closes. So this is a good indication. This thing might want to go higher, especially since we see the OBV holding nicely throughout the week, for the day, and also in the after market. Any extension to your targets? Moderna is another one of those virus-related stocks. So now it's just following this tree. This one had a good pop test. It looked like it might want to make a move. He didn't. He made a move on the downside. So he came down, took out the ATMA, and I like that. The ATMA is this orange line. That's never a good indication. We are seeing some lower shadows, but price continues to make lower highs and lower lows. So that's the indication of a downtrend. In this case, it's a pullback, so it might come here to test the 50 simple moving average. This company is the only one that is the first one that's making the vaccine and is being tested on the first, I think, 40 people. So the first one to test on human. Anyway, again, with this vaccine, there is a long wait. So nothing to do quite yet. But keep an eye on those three. Still, I know, big resistance of this one here, 31. If it breaks out of this area, 36 and 41. NVAX. Yes, there is a fourth one, NVAX. This is also a virus-related company. This we trade as day trade through here, or very nicely, a swing here back in February, end of February. and made the three of them move, and two they pulled back, and two they big pop on huge volume. Not a good close, but good enough. Reached the target at 14, and then they pulled back. This one I want to extend. If he does, next target is 17.57. One of the runs was approved by the FDA today. And then 21.99 and 27.56. The support is 12 and 10. And then I'm going to show you the inverse ETF. Now, those ones are inverse ETF you trade when market moves down. Obviously, today we got a bounce, so those are moving down. Now, let's see. How far down those come? We had a nice couple of days yesterday, and then prior to yesterday, the market was rolling over those beautiful days here, and then all the way through March. So fantastic, 50-70% gains. And now they're pulling back. So this could be a pullback consolidation, 1, 2, 3, down to possibly 33 for the SPS. That's our second support. Those one, if you trade those one, you want to refer back to the specific index. For the SDS is the SPY, so you watch what the SPY does, and you match with the SDS, and you trade it based on the SPY. Yeah? Inverse moves the opposite. However, this is a two-time inverse here, so moves that twice as fast, and they're all designed to expire, so the channel lines, the diagonal lines, are not exactly the same. They move a bit lower. QQQ, same thing as the NDX, this is the inverse ETF for the NDX. And a good move, it looks like it's breaking out at least partially, at least channel, or possible mid-channel. The SQQQ breaking down, and much bigger than the NDX, because this is a three-time move. So you make a lot of money, but if you're not careful and you don't close the position in the right place, you can lose a lot of money. They're leveraged three times as fast. This could come down and test now the 50 simple moving average. Let's see what it does at that level. And again, watch what the index is doing. In this case, the NDX. And finally, TZA. TZA also is diversity for the Russell 2000. IWM is the ETF for the Russell 2000. A couple of days ago, and yesterday I mentioned, this is making a base with the lower shadows. When you see a bunch of lower shadows, that's an indication it's raised, especially on the command level. For this one was 95. Then we popped up one of three, extending, closing my target at 109 and above the ATMA. In extension, this we could see 115 and 120, and it could be back inside this falling channel. And as a result, the TZA, the inverse ETF for the Russell 2000, rolled over, broke out the channel, moved to the ATMA, this orange line, and now is heading down. So for now, with this inverse ETF, now trade them carefully, because we might see for the next week or 2 weeks until market continues to make a possible bounce, those will continue to make down, move down, or make some kind of correction, either sideways or lower. But keep an eye on it, because if the market rolls over and the fear kicks in again, then those will run one more time. And finally, Zoom. Zoom one was a fantastic trade. This is, I mentioned before, this is the only office open for business. This is the online platform many people, many businesses are using. I gave you an entry opportunity here when it was 114. Attempted this breakout. The breakout happened. Volumes are coming in. Reached first target, 121, 130. Reached the fourth target, the 139. And my fifth target, the 151. Yesterday, blowout and reached my last target, the 163. When you have some moves from 114 to 163, that's a 40% move. Anything above 10%, folks, if you are a swing trader, take your profit. Start scaling off. Take a half position off, a third position off. Because then, you know, when something gets discovered, everybody buys. And what happens? People sell, institutions sell, money sell, traders sell, and then the uninformed investors or traders buy. Now this one, is it done now? Possibly it will come down and retest maybe Zyra here, 129, right there. Or maybe a further down to the channel bottom. Is a possibility. He did it here. He rallied, reached the channel top, and then he back, reached the channel bottom. It could be doing something similar. I will expect a sideways move and then possibly a pullback, especially if some companies open up some of the offices again, linked obviously the exposure. But anyway, this one for now, for us, is done. We're looking for now maybe another entry. Look for those support, 130, 122, and then channel bottom, that will be near 118, 120 area. Where in that area. That's it. And if this thing turns around and keeps on going, next targets, a move about 163, 178, 195, 215, and 235. Right, folks, thanks for watching. Good trading. See you tomorrow.